and made probably what, 20, what did I make back then? 10 bucks an hour? I'm not even sure. I don't even think I paid for the driving or whatever it was. And I just thought, you know, I got to do what I want to do and I got to do what I love. And if luck, as luck would have it, my friend who went to Duke with me got a job at Billboard magazine and she turned it down. And I thought, oh, this is great. If I can get this job at Billboard, then I can get my parents off my back, still have a job, make some money, and do my garage band stuff at night. This will be a good plan. And it actually was a great plan. Because I went there and I learned everything you needed to know about music. I knew it. So when I finally left my job, nobody could screw with me. I knew every which way a contract was. I knew about publishing. I knew about all the stuff that you needed to know. And, you know, there was another lesson in that, that sometimes you don't get in the way you want, but just get in the door and figure it out. Just work really hard when you're in that door and someone will recognize you. And if I hadn't taken that job at Billboard, I would not have given my CD tape to the dance editor there, who at the time was Larry Flick, who I told him it was my friend. Because I thought, God, if he hates me, I could see him every day. It would be disastrous. I told him, of course, it was my friend. And he listened to it, and he comes running. And, you know, that period of time before I actually heard his feedback, I created a new route to my desk because I couldn't go near him because I thought, oh God, he's going to tell me today, he's going to tell me I suck, and then it's just going to crush me, and I'm going to want to stay in bed for the rest of my life. But he actually came over and he said, you know, your friend is really good. And I said, really? It's me. And he was like, yeah, whatever. Your friend, though, she's really, I'm like, no, it's me. And he's like, girl, that ain't you. I was like, no, it is. I know I'm very easy spirit pumped right now. I'm the secretary, but it's really me. And he gave my CD to a publisher, and it started my career. And he's indirectly the guy who hooked me up with Paula Abdul to write Spinning Around. So I've had all of these kind of interventions in my life. Intervention. Which leads me to our next song. Was that a good segue?
That was awesome.
That was a great segue. I want to sing the song so you can see how good of a segue that was. Hold on. And then we'll talk about how we wrote it.
We got to stand up and play this song.
Okay. And I may have to look at the lyric for a second because you know how I am with my lyrics. When you write a song, dear, you all start to sound like one of them.